I'm from the University of Utah, not Germany. Let's start with a few questions. Do you walk to your workplace, or your kids back to school, or your parents take a public transit to grocery store? If you seldom walk or bike or take a transit, why is that? Is the distance too far to walk, or is the transit not available? Those questions about how we travel can make a big difference about our health and the climate change. So, Homer Hoyt said, urban form is principally a product of the dominant transportation system in a region that when the region is growth. So many US cities cater to automobile and deal with a lot of problems like urban sprawl, increased greenhouse gas emissions, and greater obesity. So walking and biking can mitigate those climate change and improve public health. But for many years, walking and biking has not been included in regional transportation plans for many regions, and especially for the needs of different age groups like students and seniors. So here are some facts. In 1969, half of the students walked or biked to school, and only one out of nine drove to school. However, today the result reversed. Only one out of eight students walk or bike to school, and half of them drive to school. And also, at the same time, the students who are obese increased from 7% to 17%. And also, as we know, US population is aging. The population aged 65 and older will double in the next 40 years. When people are getting old, they have different travel needs and different travel behavior. And they want to leave their home or communities as long as possible. So my dissertation helps aim to study the relationship between the built environment, how we build the cities, and how that impact people's travel behavior by using the data across the US and with consistent variables. I hope the result will help planners to create a built environment that can encourage people of all ages use more active transportation, thereby improve their health and the health of the environment.